Hello and welcome to our second day of live coverage from the judo venue of the 30th Universiade here in Naples. We're in the Ultramare Exhibition Centre just to the southwest of the city with a capacity of a couple of thousand spectators. Joining me in commentary is world silver medalist master Lincoln Hahn.
Good evening, Alec. Thank you for having me here again.
We're going to get underway with the first of the two bronze medal matches in the women's 57 kilos. Jisoo Kim of Korea up against Brazilian Catalin Nascimento. Jisoo Kim of Korea will be in white, and Nascimento of Brazil will be in blue. The two women taking their places. Kim, just 18 years old, facing 21-year-old Nascimento of Brazil for this bronze medal in the women's 57 kilo.
Straight away with an Ouchigari attempt. Now she's working on a turnover, and she manages just miss landing her opponent onto her back. As long as Kim keeps this rate of attack, then she could force a third penalty on her opponent.
Kim, a bronze medalist at the World Junior Championships a couple of years ago. Picked up a bronze. Need to land them on their backs to score.
But she just missed a little bit of that rotation to land Nascimento onto her side or her back.
Kim will feel that she's building momentum, not just in this fight, but all season. Here she is fighting for bronze at the Universiade. And she's managed bronze already this year at the Grand Slam in Paris. Oh, third penalty for the Brazilian. And so the match is decided on penalties in the end. Jisoo Kim of Korea, 18 years old, takes the bronze medal here, beating Catalin Nascimento. The next bronze medal match in the women's 57 kilos. This time it's Natalia Golomidova of Russia against Maria Skora of the Ukraine. Russian will be in white, the Ukrainian will be wearing blue. And Golomidova, a European under 23 silver medalist a couple of years ago, and she'll be wanting to bring that experience to this match.
Well, they came starting strong. With the first attack.
Yeah, we're operating a golden score at this Universiade. So at least a couple of matches go to 2 minutes on the golden score.
Look at that transition there. Scored a first Vazari with an Ouchigari, major inner reef.
Advantage scorer, and Wazari up. The Russian knows she's got to come up with something.
Something's going to happen. Big Uchimata for Golomidova.
And she has just taken the match against the run of play. There was an extra spurt of energy from the Russian, and it paid off with an ippon. So Natalia Golomidova, the 24-year-old Russian, takes the bronze medal here in Naples. But who will take the gold medal? Will it be the Japanese Kana Tomizawa, or will it be Gaetan Debert of France? Both obviously guaranteed a medal. One will get the gold, one will get the silver. Which way round will it be? Kana Tomizawa of Japan, just 19 years old on the left-hand side there, and the 20-year-old Gaetan Debert of France. Come here. 26 judoka have competed here this afternoon in this weight category. We're down to the final two for gold and silver.
And impressively, both managed to win all their previous four fights by ippons. So this should be decided also by big technical score. Oh, already big action. The Sotogari from Tomizawa. Lippert has a really good kumikata. She has very good grip fighting, as typical of the French school. Now on the ground again.
Thought she was in trouble, but she managed to grab the Japanese leg. Oh, it's free, and now the hold begins.
Yuko Shiugatami, side four corner pin. That's a hard one to get out.
I think Debe is stuck there now, and she's got the Wazari. Two Wazaris making a con. And Tomizawa of Japan, 19 years old, wins the gold medal here at the Summer Universiade in Naples. Disappointment for Debe, but silver nonetheless for the French 20-year-old.
And as we have seen here, Tomizawa is relentless on the ground. And that's what won her the match.
So, the first of the medal matches in the next category, the women's 63 kilo category. And it'll be between the Mongolian, Masunjagal Bayabat, and Renata Zakova of the Czech Republic.
Bayabat came in here with five previous matches. Well, Zakova came in here with four previous matches.
Mongolia always a strong nation at judo. Got the throw in this time for Wazari.
And the Mongolians just looking to kill time there on the ground by being active. As long as she appears active, they're not going to stop the clock.
Well, with a second on the clock, the medal is going to the Mongolian. Sanjagal Bayabat of Mongolia wins the bronze medal with a Wazari against Zakova of the Czech Republic. Zakova just never felt she managed to quite get into the match quite as much as Bayabat. Bayabat control things from the start. Who will get the second bronze in this category? Camilla Badarova of Russia, or will it be Yi-Ju Han of Korea? Russia on the left-hand side of white. Camilla Badarova up against Yi-Ju Han of Korea for the second bronze medal match in the 63 kilo category. When you watch top-level judo, often you realize that the fighters have fought each other so many times.
Oh,
another foot sweep. Wazari.
The Ashibarai, advancing foot sweep from the Russian. As I said earlier, you've got to really watch out for those.
Badarova, former silver medalist in the European Under-23 Championships. She's about to become a bronze medalist at the 30th Universiade here in Naples. Camilla Badarova of Russia wins it with a Wazari.
The winner of the bronze medal for Russia.
That is Russia's second medal of the day. Second bronze medal, too. The gold medal match now in the women's 63 kilo category. It's Nana Kota of Japan against Gekke Vandenberg of the Netherlands, with the Dutch athlete in the blue. This will be Netherlands' first medal in the judo here at the Universiade in Naples.
Definitely a lot of leg techniques could help her because she has that longer reach. She could get better grips, grip more quickly because she has a longer reach. And then when she gets them, she could use her legs for Osotogari or Ouchigari. But it was Kota who started with the first Osotogari. Taking down Vandenberg, not for a score, but enough to start a transition on the ground. Vandenberg does a very smart thing to trap her opponent's both feet. Kota's working hard.
To hold the Japanese legs as well.
Oh, look at that.
Oh, but she's got the hold on.
It starts. Yuko Shiogatami. Side four corner hold.
Grab the legs. So the hold is off.
Well, she has to actually cross her feet once she trapped the leg in order for the pin to be broken. She only had the top part of her leg and not the bottom part.
So the hold counted, and it was for long enough to give Nana Kota of Japan the win by Ippon and the gold medal here at the Universiade. So in this case, size didn't matter.
No, but she could have used those legs to trap her opponent if she had a little bit more time, but she didn't have enough time to escape. So good work to Kota. That's what I'll say to her opponent.
Second gold medal of the day for the Japanese. Their third gold medal overall here at the judo, 30th Universiade. Well, that's the women done for the day. Let's move on to the men, 73 kilo category. Two bronze medal matches coming up. The first between Choi Gwang Kim of North Korea and Zogbatar Sendochir of Mongolia.
The match will be originating by the entry from Italia.
Taking place, fifth place at last year's Asian Games. But I was impressed to see.
In white for the Democratic People Republic of Korea, Kim Jong-wang.
Mongolia's picked up a penalty, but they've got just over a minute to try and break down the man in front of them.
Pushing forward, Kim drops down for a technique, gets it.
And it's an Ippon for the Korean. Choi Gwang Kim just pulls off that throw and the Mongolian is distraught. Really, really disappointed with himself. So the People's Republic of Korea claim their first judo medal at this Universiade, and it's bronze thanks to Choi Gwang Kim. Second bronze medal will be contested between Marko Gusic of Montenegro and Kikmatilok Turev of Uzbekistan. So Gusic of Montenegro, 21 years old, facing off against the 24-year-old from Uzbekistan.
Gusic came in with five previous fights. Turayev had four previous fights. Stable, very strong, explosive fighter. He's an expert in his native Uzbek wrestling. Now you can see this is a dangerous situation, could go either way. Oh, look at cat-like ability of Turiyev to get out. Now trying to escape, and he manages to turn against his opponent. Wow.
The Uzbek Kistani is given the opponent.
Look at that.
Well, I'm looking forward to watching that again in slow mo.
Oh, yes.
That happened so quickly. So the bronze medal claimed by Turiyev of Uzbekistan with 3 minutes 11 still on the clock. An extraordinary victory for him. The big one comes next. Evgeny Prokopchuk of Russia take on Hidayat Haydarov of Azerbaijan. The Azerbaijani in blue, the Russian in white. This is for gold and silver.
This is a very interesting lineup because they've had some very tough fights. Prokopchuk had 4 fights before, and Hidayrov had 5 fights. Both of them have quality opponents. Look at that lift. Reverse shoulder throw from Haydarov.
Haydarov, very much the man of the moment. Time for one more action.
One complete action here. I have a feeling we're going to golden score very soon. Oh, Diego Sotogari from the Russian. Comes out.
Could have just done it, couldn't he?
Those are such high caliber players.
So, our first golden score period of the day. Vasari for the Russian and gold for Prokopchuk. That's 3 medals to Russia today, but their first gold of the day.
Well, Prokopchuk has proven to be unstoppable all day, and he definitely finished the final in style. Haydarov is in disbelief. Great fight by both fighters. Really. Prokopchuk has another medal. Out of all the 3 competitions he entered this year, major ones, he has won
hugely experienced. And this will be his last Universiade as well, because he's 25 years old, so he won't be able to qualify for the next one. So he goes away with a gold medal in his last Universiade.
What a way to conclude it.
The final medal matches in the men's 81 kilo category. Janos Hundfeldt of Germany will take on Dorin Gotonoaga of Moldova. So Hundfeldt on the left. This is for the first of 2 bronze medals available in the men's 81 kilos.
Throw, get countered. Azari. Fell, came across for a hip sweep, Haraigoshi. Maybe he's listening to our advice.
He doesn't want to listen to my advice.
But gets pushed onto his back. That scores Confield and Vasari. So now they're both even.
Twist round, so he didn't land on his back.
I'm so impressed by the Moldovan's ability to turn out from these big attacks.
Time's up.
Well,
couldn't get more even than that, could you? Wasari each, penalty each, into gold and score.
German coach. Just got frustrated. Oh, that is an ippon.
That's a huge ippon from Gotenorata.
What a throw. And the German landing full square on his back. Gotenorata takes the bronze medal. And that is Moldova's first judo medal at these Universiads. Second of the bronze medal contest between Tato Grigalashvili of Georgia and Abbas Azizov of Russia. What's happening here then?
Well, it looks like the Russian was injured, so he couldn't continue to fight for this bronze medal, unfortunately for him.
Tato Grigalashvili of Georgia has just been given this fight, and therefore the bronze medal. The gold and silver will be fought for between Jin Lee of Korea and the Japanese Hikaru Tomokuyo. And actually, it's inevitable that it's going to happen sooner or later.
That's true.
Oh,
big throw.
Big throw. Given a Wasari.
Straight into the ground warp. So the Japanese, from two penalties down, is now Wasari up.
What a transition there with that triangle hold.
Just can't keep the Korean on the mat.
Calling a score. Tomokuyo continues.
On the ground. Tomokuyo trying to pin the Korean down.
And now the
hold is on.
Well, the Korean overturned Tomokuyo's effort. And now the Korean is holding the Japanese down. Wow. So close.
Oh,
big, big throw.
Tomokuyo gets the throw in. Oh. Finally, so pulls it close. Off.
What a finish.
And that gives Hikaru Tomokuyo the gold medal in this category. Japan's third gold of the day, their fourth overall in the judo after 2 days of competition. And you can see the disappointment on Lee's face. Well, there's confirmation of the gold medal going to Hikaru Tomokuyo of Japan.